Hey, peace, family. That's my homeboy right there, Cujo. I don't know if some of y'all remember, but I mean, older people might remember. But I remember that Killer Dog, the Killer Dog movie named Cujo. All right, so that's my. You know what I mean? I named my cat after that dog and shit. But that's Cujo right there. But tell y'all a quick story, man. When we was in the before we had got the apartment we was in, I was staying in another hotel room. So most of my earlier videos is out of that hotel room window, right? But when we were staying there, this cat right here, Cujo, he was a kitten. Maybe like 8 months or something like that. And I used to have the window open at night filming the orbs and the ancestors and shit. So this one night I left the window kind of cracked open and I went to sleep. So maybe 10 o'clock in the morning, like his mom wakes me up and she said, I can't find Cujo. She said, I looked everywhere. I even pulled this snack bag out. Usually we shake the snack bag. He'll come like from under the bed or whatever, because he loves these little chicken snacks we get. So he'll come out. So she said, I pulled the snack bag out and was looking for him. He didn't come out. So I get up, I'm looking for him. And then I look towards the window and I see that the window is open. So I'm like, oh shit. Now I'm on the fourth floor. So I go downstairs, right? Yo, this story is so crazy. I go downstairs. It's hot as hell. It's an August morning. So I go downstairs. I'm looking for him and shit. So I'm looking on in front of the hotel. So I go around the back of the hotel. When I get around the back, it's an older black dude standing on the sidewalk, and he has his bag in his hand. So he got both his hands, like he got the bag in front of him in one hand. He has both his hands on the handle, holding the bag in front of him. Right, he's just smiling, like he's just looking straight, smiling like he look like damn near like a statue or something. So I'm walking past him and he's smiling, but something is telling me to ask him, did he see the cat? Right now he's in the back of the building, so as I'm walking past, he's smiling. I'm looking at him, I'm like, I just got a feeling to ask him. So I go over to him, I said, excuse me. And he turned his head towards me like, yes man, how you doing today? So I'm like, how you doing, man? I was like, did you happen to see a cat out here? He said, yes, I saw him, a black cat. It's under the truck in front of the hotel. So I'm like, oh shit, you saw him? He said, yeah, he's under the truck. And he turned his head from me and kept smiling. So I'm like, I take off running around the building. And I look back, the dude was gone. So I'm like, what the fuck? So I run in the front. I'm looking under the truck. I don't see him. So I'm like, damn. So I run towards the street. I'm like, damn, I hope he ain't like get hit or nothing. So I'm looking for him. So I run towards the street and I'm looking up and down the street. And as I like just turn my head backwards to look back towards the truck, and I see him under the truck, like in between the tires, and he's like looking up at me. So I'm like, oh shit, Cujo. So I run over there to him, and yo, he under the truck, his mouth bleeding. His hand is like folded up, and he's like his jaw is like that, like he's like shivering, like, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, oh man. So I think he broke his jaw on the fall, right? So I tried to like, I reached under the truck, I'm petting him, trying to calm him down, but he like keep digging his claws into the asphalt, like he don't want me to move him. So he also likes to climb in boxes, like shoe boxes. So I had on, I put the shoe box. Let me see, cause he like that. I'm trying to wake him up. Cujo, what's up, man? So, all right. So I was sitting next to him on the floor, just petting him, and then she ran upstairs and got a shoe box with a towel in it, and I sat the box next to him, and he came and crawled in the box. So boom, I put him in the box. And I run upstairs. So when I get him upstairs in the room, he runs under the bed, and he goes to the bathroom under the bed. He never did that. He always goes to his litter box and, you know what I mean, his little food tray and his water bowl. I never had a problem with him going to the bathroom on the floor, but he's like, He in himself. He like he shivering, he shaking, his jaw was bleeding, his foot. Now then I noticed that he keep like favoring his foot. So when I went to like look at his paw, his foot was broke. So I'm thinking he must have, you know how they say cats land on their feet. So I'm thinking he, as he was falling, he must have put his paws down first and he broke his paw and hit his face on the street. You know what I'm saying? I mean, on the asphalt. So I'm like, damn, man. So he basically fucked up. He fucked up. So I'm telling her, I'm like, man, I'm gonna have to take him to the vet or something by the morning. If I can't get him right, I'm gonna take him to the vet. I'm not letting him put him to sleep, but I'm gonna take him to the vet and see if he good, right? So the rest of the day, I'm just trying to like, you know, I'm like trying to give him water and just try to make him feel better, feel comfortable and shit, but he hurting. So I'm like, damn, man. So later on that night, I go to the window and it's a light orb outside, right? So I just asked him. I said, ancestors, could y'all please fix my cat? Man, I don't want him to die. I don't want my, you know what I mean? I don't want to have to explain that to my kids. They're going to be heartbroken too. I was like, man, I love him. I like, can you please like help him? So I put him in his little cat bed and I left him like by the window almost. And, you know, of course I closed it this time, but I left him by the window and I went to sleep. So, all right, around like 5 o'clock that morning, I'm laying on my back, but like my face, like my head is like, you know, my face is like up facing the ceiling. So I'm laying on my back and I hear, meow, meow, right? So I like open my eyes a little bit. Then I hear, meow, meow, meow. So when he did it again, I remembered like, you know, out of my sleep, I remember like he was hurt. Like, oh shit, Cujo. So I sit up and I look around and I look, he's sitting on the floor next to me, like on his butt, right? And he has his hand folded, but he's like looking up at me. Like, he's totally different now. So he's like, wow, wow. But I notice his jaw's not like, his jaw's not doing that open close shit no more, like shaking shit. And he like, he just look up, he look woke, like he up. So I'm like, I reach down to pick him up and I put him on my chest. And he like licked my face. And he jumps down off my chest and goes to his water bowl. I'm like, oh shit, they fixed him. So he goes to the water. Now, mind you, before this, he wasn't eating, he wasn't drinking, he was going to the bathroom under the bed, like he was messed up. So he jump off me, he goes to the water bowl, drinks the water, goes in the bathroom where his litter box is. So I like followed him. He goes in there, does his thing in the litter box, comes out, grabs his toy. I'm like, oh shit. So they fixed him, bro. You know what I'm saying? They fixed him. It fucked me up, man. But I got a couple more stories like that too. Like they did some shit for me already, you know what I mean? But yes, they fixed him. So basically I'm telling y'all, man, if y'all seen those light orbs and y'all having troubles or whatever, or problems, like ask them, man. Ask them for some help, man. They even made me comfortable since we had the fire. You know what I'm saying? Different things been happening, you know what I mean? Like just, you know, not to where we're good, but we're comfortable, you know what I'm saying? And even with y'all help, man, you know what I mean, making that possible. So, but yeah, basically, man, I'm telling y'all that story. Like y'all see those light orbs, there's a reason, man. Like y'all ask them to help y'all. Ask them for help, ask them to heal y'all. Just see what happens, man. Like believing, and the power is in believing. Like when I asked them to help Cujo, I didn't even worry about it no more. Like I asked them and I just felt like they was gonna do it. Cause before that story, they did something for me personally. You know what I'm saying? And I tell you that story too. But yeah, that's one of my ancestor stories, light orb stories where they helped me, man. All right. But this the homie right here, Cujo. This is foot. This foot right here was broken. See? Look. This foot right here. This one right. Oh, is that one? Or is this one? It was one of them. You see, they both working though, so he's a little sleepy right now. But yeah, this is for homeboy, man. All right, that's Cujo, and this is the lava. Look, she right here next to me. Look, that's my daughter right there. So she like laying on my daughter and shit. But yeah, they came here this morning, and just jumped on the bed, and went to sleep. So I let them stay here. You know what I mean? All right, but quick story, family. All right, that's Cujo, my homeboy. Love him to death. All right. These are my first two cats too, fam. I was a dog person. I never had cats before, so this is new to me. But, all right, little story for y'all, man. Remember, ask the light orbs for help, man. They love you like you love them, man. All right? All right, peace, family.